Hi guys, welcome to a PowerPoint for Scientists. So in this lecture, we're going to learn how to create a graphical abstract. So first, we need to know what is the requirement of the journal we publish it in. So what is the requirement for the graphical abstract? And second, we're going to learn how to design a graphical abstract, a simple yet effective one. And lastly, I'm going to show you what are the useful resources that you can use to create the graphical abstract for your publication. So let's go ahead and dive into the lecture, how to create a graphical abstract. So first thing, to find what is the requirement for the graphical abstract, you just search graphical abstract guideline and then type in the name of the journal you are targeted to, like Nature or Science. So in this example, I'm going to use the requirement of Elsevier, which is the popular publisher. So you can see that on this side, they have the guideline for the specification of the graphical abstract. So the image size, they say use the ratio of 200 high and 500 wide. So the ratio is 2 by 5. So we'll create a box of 2 by 5 of ratio. So create a box, height you put 2 and width is 5. And then now we can go to change it to no fill. And the line, I would change it into black color. And then now we have this box ratio of 2 by 5, and you can scale it out. So your graphical abstract design will need to fit inside this box. And also they have other requirements like the font and also the file type like TIFF, EPS or PDF. So the good graphical abstract is a clear, simple, and deliver the most important point of your research. So here are a few examples of the graphical abstract in Nature Review Journal. So you can see that they have a similar type. So the best one is the one that explains the relationship of different factors like this. So I'm gonna add this picture into our PowerPoint, and I'm going to show you how we can recreate this graphical abstract. So you can see the ratio is different with our ratio of Elsevier. So in this lecture, we're going to recreate a portion of this figure. So we're going to create this portion here. So I'm going to crop it. And then we're gonna search the picture. So first we're gonna search bacteria icon and choose the icon that we like. So you guys can check out the previous lecture that I show you the tips and tricks to create a graphical abstract or the figure. So I'm gonna go relatively quick. How to do, first we'll remove the background because they have the white background around. See, I can zoom it smaller. Oh, sorry for this one. And then we will change the color to prevent the copyright issue. So we have green, blue, maybe I will change it into blue and make it smaller, rotate it around, and it more or less new figure. So to copy, you can hold Alt, or in the new version, you can hold right click and drag it. So you can quickly duplicate any figure or shapes. It's a very cool feature. So I'm gonna go fast forward and show you how to do the rest of the graphical abstract. Gonna search for human, drag it in, change color, search for a predator, maybe a lion, maybe the one that like chasing. We need to remove background, remove all the white part, and now it's good. Make it smaller and change the color. So now we need to create a curved arrow that represents interaction between them. You can choose arc and hold shift to make it ratio. So the best way to create is make it a circle like this, and then we will duplicate it. So at the end you can create a perfectly circle relationship. So adjust it and turn it back to quarter like this, and then hold right click, you can duplicate it, put it on top, and then you can adjust the weight end and start like this. Just drag the yellow dot and then hold right click to duplicate it, and then adjust the yellow dot for the start and end point. So you can see that we create the perfect circle of relationship among them. So we will just make a small adjustment to make it center a little bit on the right, and choose the three arc, and then we will change to the arrow. So shape arrows and choose two side arrows and increase the width of the line maybe to 4 point. So you can see now we have a perfect circle. And then I will choose the neutral color. I'll choose gray. And now you can add text bulb to the requirement font of the journal. So in this type, I'm gonna choose zero. This will be pathogens. And change to maybe 14 point font. And Apple E to centralize it. And maybe change it into gray. So you can copy this. This is human. And then right click, drag to copy. We have predators. So you can see that we can quickly create this graphical abstract, which is very clear, simple, but show the interaction of the three factor. And what we're missing is the title box in the middle. So create a box, and in the nature style, we will choose gradient field. You can choose radial and then center it. So you can adjust this until it's clear. And you can put edit text or just simply copy the text box. So this figure shows the evolutionary pressures. So we can adjust it. So we're all done. We can see this is very powerful abstract. So to export it, you click File, Export, move it to desktop, and I will choose JPEG or TIFF or PNG. So JPEG, and you can always increase this maybe like 3000, and it will keep the ratio of the width and height. And to export it, you will have the very high quality JPEG. So you can see that when I zoom in, it's still not breaking. So you can check the DPI, make sure it's 300 DPI. So you can see that this is how you can manually create the graphical abstract. But they have another program, is mindthegraph.com. So this is a perfect online software that you can use to create a graphical abstract. So after you log in, you can choose icon and you can search all the icons here, for example bacteria. So all of these icon and photo is free of copyright, so you can freely use it and just choose the one that fit for your research. So the next one will be human. So this software is mainly designed for the science field. So you can see that they have a lot of figure about science and cell. So it will benefit for you guys who work about science. So so check out this website, and I think it's a very cool website that if you want to quickly create a nice graphical abstract without worry about the copyright issue. So that's all for today, guys. Thank you very much for listening, and I will see you in the next lecture.